Welcome to Electrified. It's your host, Dylan Loomis. Hope you all had a great weekend and your week is off to a good start. First up today, Elon said that Sonic the Hedgehog, the classic game, is coming to all Teslas. Now, this one wasn't personally in my rotation back in the day, but the more options, the merrier. And here I'd like to give a shout out to Jigar Patel on Twitter. I will link his account below because he was the artist responsible for putting this together, and I just thought it was really cool and well done and wanted to share. So go check him out and some of his other NFT art as well. It's pretty awesome stuff. I came across this image over the weekend from a Bloomberg terminal. It's for Tesla deliveries. It is the annual consensus for year over year. And looking at the 2022 figures for the end of next year, the annual consensus is 1.284 million deliveries. And then for 2023, they have 1.6 million. Now, I personally think there's at least an outside chance that if the ramps at Austin and Berlin go well next year, then this number would be in play, this 1.6 number, actually in 2022. The point here being, I believe Wall Street estimates for Tesla deliveries next year are too low, and if Tesla can indeed exceed these numbers, that will lead to revisions and changing of price targets, and it's only gonna mean good things for Tesla stock next year. And this right here was one of the funniest tweets I saw this weekend from Earl of Frunkpuppy. Cyber Wiper replacement being delivered to Tesla. This was just too good. But the good news here is that if you're worried about this massive wiper blade, Elon did say over the weekend that is not the production wiper. This right here was just a masterpiece of engineering. So this gentleman, Thomas Massey, basically took a Model S Plaid battery pack from a wreck and repurposed it to power his home. So I'm going to link this Reddit thread below if you're into this type of stuff. As you can see, he built it and programmed it in C on a Pi. So this is wildly impressive as it's been 24 hours per day with zero interruptions for 4 years, according to Thomas. So like I said, if you want to check out more about it, link to this thread below. TechAU shared this screenshot from a Chinese Tesla and translated the image. It says, uneven tire wear, the depth of the rear tire tread is too low. Make an appointment for tire inspection and rotation. So potentially a new feature coming to Tesla where it'll alert you if one, your tread is too low, and two, if the wear on your tires is uneven. So a very cool feature to have. Elon said FSD 10.7 next week is great. This was on December 11th. So maybe around December 18th, we can expect 10.7. And he said it should arguably be called 11, which is a big deal because that's typically when we get the bigger steps forward. So could this be the single stack neural net that people have been talking about for the last few months? It's possible, but as always, we will just wait and see. And rewinding a bit, it looks like some users are going to skip version 10.6 and they're just going to be upgraded from version 10.5 to 10.6.1. And it seems as though this wasn't just one or two people, but there were multiple people in the comments here sharing that this was their experience as well. Here we have another article, this one from Joey at Teslarati, about a Mach-E reportedly charging at a Tesla supercharger with an adapter. Now, there was no confirmation inside the vehicle that the car was actually being charged. It was just seemingly plugged in, but as we know, that doesn't mean the car is receiving power. So did this car do this for the parking spot, or is this car actually charging? You can't really tell, but let me know, what do you guys think? Is Tesla low-key opening up some of these new superchargers to non-Tesla vehicles here in the States and just not telling anybody? Or are these reports just speculation and there's no actual charging here taking place? For me, I lean toward the latter, but I would not be surprised in the slightest because Elon did say this, talking about the superchargers being opened up. It's kind of low key. Tesla superchargers are being made accessible to other electric cars. That was back December of 2020. This morning, Gary Black on his YouTube channel, The Future Fund, did a live stream talking about Tesla and some other things. Now, luckily, I was able to actually record this video, so I have it, because looking at his channel right now, it seems as though there are no videos. I don't know if this is just a glitch. I don't know if you guys are able to see the two videos this channel had uploaded. I was just gonna show you a brief clip, but now I'm gonna show you a few clips just in case you can't actually see the full video for whatever reason. But hopefully, you know, this is just a problem on my end and you guys can see the content on his channel. But either way, here are the highlights to what he said.
Let me start by talking about the management visit. We went on a tour of Fremont. It's an incredible thing to do if folks haven't done it. It's just so high tech, so automated. most of the process is fully automated at this point. And one of the things that I came away with, and I know Dave came away with, is, you know, as they add new factories, so as Austin comes online, as Berlin comes online, all the technology and all the efficiencies they built into Shanghai will be even better. You know, they learned a lot in building Shanghai, and Shanghai, as you may remember, produced about 150,000 EVs its first year. We're thinking that both Berlin and Austin can do the same in 22. And I guess the one thing I would you know, say that was important to me is management still believes that both Berlin and Austin will come online at the end of the year. And for those that, you know, they watch the drone videos that are out there, it looks like there's a huge flurry of activity at both plants to try to get both of them up and running by, you know, in the next 3 weeks. One, EV adoption is going through the roof. And there's a tweet we put out this morning. There's an outfit called EV hyphen volumes. They supply volumes to all the OEMs. They're worth taking a look at. They're in Sweden. They help us out a lot on different analyses. But we looked at it by region this morning. And again, you can look at our Twitter feed and you'll see it. And what you see that in every region, EV adoption is going through the roof. They have a forecast for fourth quarter. The first three quarters are actuals, and it's just BEVs only. We exclude anything that's a hybrid. But what you see, and this is important, that for fourth quarter, their estimate for global EV adoption will be 11.6%. And that's a huge number because our forecast for all of next year, for 2022, is 10. And our forecast for all of this year was 6. And we brought that up all year. And it looks like this year, fiscal year 2021, will probably end in the 7.677 range. So I think that's a huge upside surprise. We use a 11.6% discount rate on Tesla. We get that by, we use a 2% 10-year treasury. So we have some room on our 10-year treasury rate. It's the if you look back over the last 50 years, the premium, they call this the equity risk premium, equities versus bonds is about 6%. Okay. And then Tesla has a 1.6 beta. You have to risk adjust it. So you take 1.6 times 6, that's 9.6. You add 2%, that's 11.6% as a discount rate. Okay. And I put out some things over the weekend that, you know, every 1 percentage point increase in the 10-year treasury yield takes about 4.5% off the stock market. You multiply that times the beta of 1.6, that'll be what Tesla would be down by if interest rates start rising.
I'd like to take a moment to thank the sponsor of today's episode, Charity Stars. And guys, this is your final reminder for your chance to win a brand new Model Y Performance and $10,000. Charity Stars has increased the number of free entries this time around to 500 using my code. So check out charitystars.com/electrified and use coupon code ELECTRIFIED at checkout. And yes, the winner will get to choose interior and exterior options, which is not always the case, and the taxes and insurance will be included for United States winners. But this sweepstakes is available globally, not just for US residents. Most of us know the magic of the Model Y Performance, but if you're new, we're talking 0 to 60 in 3.5 seconds, over 300 miles of range, and an industry-leading infotainment system on a 15-inch touchscreen. And Charity Stars is a fundraising platform for charitable causes. In this case, you'll be supporting the Jamie Kimball Foundation for Courage, which funds initiatives to prevent intimate partner violence. So to enter the sweepstakes, head to charitystars.com/electrified and use coupon code ELECTRIFIED for 500 free entries on your purchase. Best of luck. Now, I'm sure most of you have seen this by now, but there was some new footage of the Tesla Semi being tested over the weekend, and Sawyer reported that the Semi is indeed in limited production. So we kind of knew this was going to come with that Pepsi CEO talking about still expecting to get their delivery of Tesla Semis the end of this year. That seems to be on track. Now, I don't want people to get carried away and think that they're gonna start producing this vehicle in volume in any stretch. It might be a situation where it's, you know, between 5 and 10 vehicles per week for the foreseeable future, at least until 4680s are really ramped up and ready to be produced at scale. Now, I actually wouldn't mind Tesla keeping some of these early produced semis to use for their own purposes, you know, transporting whether it's batteries or other components to and from Fremont and Giga Nevada, getting people to see them on the road, doing the testing, something benefiting Tesla, and of course, displacing any number of ICE semis is always going to be a great thing. And the Tesla Semi is being manufactured at a purpose-built facility at Giga Nevada. Here we had a video from Jay in Shanghai. Tesla China supercharger stalls floor lock system is now integrated into the Tesla mobile app. Previously, you had to use a third-party app, so this is definitely a step in the right direction. And just to be clear, I do think this will become completely seamless in the future. It's just Tesla is going to need time to build out that solution. MacroRP shared on Twitter, Tesla has filed a permit to build the largest supercharger in Nevada, 32 stalls coming soon to the Prim Valley Resort and Casino. And here we have that information confirmed on the permit. We got some news that Tesla got approval for the launch of 3 more models in India. Sadly, no information was given as to which models that was, at least not yet. But if this report is true, that would make it a total of 7 models that have received approval. And here we have it. Elon Musk has officially won the Person of the Year from Time for 2021. And respect to Jim Farley for congratulating Elon. Elon said, our intent with Tesla was always that we would serve as an example to the car industry. And Jim said, mission accomplished. Congrats, Elon Musk. And Tesla Bud said, thanks for the recognition, Jim. Respect. And he said, back at you and the Tesla fans. So good on Jim Farley for this. Who knows what he's really feeling inside, but either way, it's great to see Jim giving credit to Elon. Now, I just want to take a second to explain what this award is and is not. So I think a lot of people just think the person of the year is like the most successful or the most famous or, you know, the most impactful person for humanity. And to some degree, that's true. However, that is really not what this award is. It can be a positive or actually a negative thing. Here is what the criteria actually is for this award. According to Time, there's really only one criterion that determines the person of the year. They are the person or persons who most affected the news and our lives for good or ill and embodied what was important about the year. Now, to be clear, I believe Elon winning this award is definitely on the positive side, meaning he deserves it. It is a good actual award and a commendation for his success and his impact to humanity. But I think there are at least 2 people who you could probably agree that might have been on the ill side of that equation. As you can see, Adolf Hitler won this award when it was called Man of the Year in 1938, and Joseph Stalin won twice in 1939 and 1942. So just to be clear, winners of this award in the future might not be worthy of your praise and admiration. But in this case, I of course think Elon is indeed worthy of praise and admiration for what he's done for humanity. Now, to be fair, in this interview, it was about 12 minutes long between Time and Elon. It wasn't all positive. They kind of brought up some negative things and some questionable things that they thought Elon has done. So honestly, I think from Time's perspective, there was a little bit of that ill factor going into this award going to Elon. And I'll just share with you some of this interview. And of course, it'll be linked below if you'd like to watch the full thing.
Earlier this year, this Tesla crashed into a highway divider in California, killing the driver. Another slammed into a parked fire truck in Utah. Both had the autopilot feature on.
There is a federal investigation underway into the autopilot software that Tesla has, which, despite the name, is not autopilot software. It does not drive the car for you. And people inside Tesla have expressed a lot of skepticism about whether the company's technology is eventually going to be able to get there.
Are the cars safe? I mean, should I feel comfortable getting behind the wheel of a Tesla and saying, drive me where I need to go?
Well, the statistics that I think are at this point unequivocal that, you know, far more accidents off autopilot than on autopilot. So this is not to say that autopilot is perfect. Now, to get to full self-driving where you don't need to pay attention, we still obviously have a lot of work to do. So as we get to the point where interventions are extremely rare, even in complex traffic situations, and get to the point where the probability of injury with full self-driving is much lower than with a human driving, then obviously at that point it would make sense to allow the car to drive itself and not have to pay attention.
Elon Musk definitely uses Twitter in a way that no other business leader does. And it's gotten him into a lot of trouble in recent years.
His Twitter feed is juvenile, to say the least. He has insulted some important people in really immature ways. But when a person with 65 million followers and $300 billion is just having fun, that tends to create ripples in the larger pond.
You are, not to put too fine a point on it, the richest man in the history of the world and arguably the most influential. And yet you tweet freely and playfully and somewhat mischievously.
Yes, that's accurate.
Our feud with policymakers or poking Jeff Bezos, is that good for the overall brand?
Yeah, I don't really think about brand optimization, to be frank, as is obvious from my tweets, which are often self-inflicted wounds or humor that I find funny, but not necessarily that many other people find funny.
Right. You know, when you say take the red pill, do you worry about sending none too bad?
I said take both pills.
Take both. Well, that's okay. All right. Well.
Yeah.
But do you worry at all about activating, motivating the, you know, a political fringe?
Yeah, actually, when I said take the red pill, I didn't realize that was some, like, politically charged phrase.
Right.
I was just referring to The Matrix. Make sure you accept reality for what it is.
Right.
And then it turns out it's, like, also, like, some, like, accept right-wing dogma thing or something. I didn't realize that at the time.
But honestly, overall, I really couldn't think of somebody that would be more deserving of this award in the most positive sense for all that he's done and the way he has sacrificed his own health and well-being and time and relationships to better humanity. And you can say what you will about him. He's, of course, a polarizing figure, and he's not perfect. He's human, just like you and I. But congrats to the GOAT. Well deserved. And if you like space and history, then you will probably love this conversation between Elon Musk, Bill Riley, and Dan Carlin. I will link this below for your viewing pleasure. Speaking of awards, Motor Trend has awarded the Rivian R1T as the 2022 Motor Trend Truck of the Year. I'm going to link this article below, but we're not going to get into the details. But the most important takeaway for us EV fans is this. It shows us pickups can be for people who never wanted one. I think the Cybertruck will parlay that as well. And most importantly, it shows us they can be electric vehicles and be better for it. And some EPA filings came out for the Rivian R1T that are going to confirm currently a peak DC fast charging rate of 210 kilowatts. And we also learned that at least currently there is no heat pump on the R1T. And if you would like to dive into the 57-page document yourself, I've linked it below. But that is all for today. Please take a second to like the video if you did. Hope you guys have a wonderful day, and a huge thank you to all of my Patreon supporters.